Hello, I'm Sergeant Efrain Cornejo. As part of the Milwaukee Police Department's continuous commitment to be transparent with our community, we created community briefings to provide information to the public regarding officer-involved critical incidents. Community briefings are intended to provide relevant information, which may include video footage, audio recordings, photographs, and other evidence. It is our priority to release this information and inform our community as soon as possible, unless releasing the information will compromise the integrity of the investigation. When watching this video, keep in mind that this may still be an ongoing investigation. For privacy purposes, we have concealed audio and images of community members captured in this video. The video you are about to see may contain officers using force, explicit language, and disturbing images. Viewer discretion is strongly advised.
Hello, I'm Inspector Craig Sarno with the Milwaukee Police Department Administration Bureau. In this community briefing, I'm going to share with you information regarding circumstances surrounding the officer-involved shooting that occurred in the 2900 block of North 6th Street on the afternoon of Friday, February 25th, 2022. On this date, at approximately 3:03 p.m., a subject entered the Milwaukee Police Department District 5 station located at 2920 Vell R. Phillips Avenue. Surveillance video obtained from District 5 showed that the subject then walked through the lobby, which is accessible to the public, and up to the counter where he was greeted by a uniformed officer assigned to desk duty. The subject inquired about an investigation which had occurred earlier in the week, to which the officer could not provide any information about as it was an active investigation. The subject pulled out a handgun from his right pants pocket and discharged one round into the ground. Three other civilians were also present in the lobby and within several feet of the subject at this time when this occurred. The civilians immediately attempted to hide within the lobby. The officer immediately took cover behind the counter while the subject, who was still facing the counter, proceeded to take several steps backward across the lobby. The officer then slowly attempted to stand up to see where the subject was, at which time that subject fired a second shot toward the officer, nearly hitting his head, and shattered the glass partition in the process.
Can we help you
The subject then fired a third shot toward the counter area. It should be noted that several other department members, both sworn and civilian, were also present in the area behind that officer and immediately dove for cover. When the subject fired his weapon, at this time, another officer emerged from a work area behind the counter and discharged his service weapon at the subject, who then exited that police station. An officer then notified the dispatcher and other squads over the radio what had just transpired. What you're about to hear is that officer's radio transmission.
3324 got shots fired at the district. Get down.
The armed subject fled from the district station and into the nearby Harumbi neighborhood. Numerous officers immediately responded to the area and began to search for the armed subject on foot in the surrounding residential community. An officer who was responding to the area located the armed subject and ordered him to drop his weapon. The armed subject refused, turned towards the officer, at which time the officer discharged his weapon. The armed subject then continued to flee.
Shots fired!
Officers subsequently located him behind a residential house in the 2900 block of North 6th Street and still armed with a firearm. Officers repeatedly gave the subject verbal commands to relinquish his firearm, which he refused. The subject then pointed his firearm towards the officers, at which time several officers discharged their service weapons at the subject, causing him to fall towards the ground and drop his weapon.
Drop the gun!
Drop the gun!
Officers then approached the subject, secured his firearm, and placed him under arrest. The subject sustained multiple gunshot wounds as a result. He was treated on scene by officers and subsequently transported to a local hospital for treatment.
Stay with us, okay?
Yeah.
You're gonna stay with us now.
Come on.
All right.
Hey. Is that the gun? Is that the gun?
Hurry up. Anybody else with you?
Don't touch him.
Right there. Don't touch him. Anybody else with you? No?
He's got
the
right arm here.
Do you have the tourniquet?
Get a tourniquet on his right arm. Or his left arm. Here. I'm grabbing his ID. I'm grabbing his wallet. Check his ID.
Everyone okay? Stopwatch.
Yeah, we're good.
His gun.
Located next to the subject was a .40 caliber Smith & Wesson semi-automatic pistol. Subsequent investigation revealed that the three spent casings recovered in the District 5 station matched the firearm recovered from the suspect. The subject's gunfire caused damage to the District 5 lobby and front office area. This investigation is still ongoing, and due to an abundance of caution, is being led by the Milwaukee Area Investigative Team with the West Dallas Police Department as the lead agency. No department personnel, sworn or civilian, as well as the members of the community that were present within the District 5 lobby were injured during this incident. As a result of department policy, the officers involved were placed on administrative duty pending the outcome of the investigation. The defendant was treated for his injuries at a local hospital and released several days later. On March 1, 2022, the Milwaukee County District Attorney's Office subsequently charged the defendant with attempt first-degree intentional homicide and numerous other felonies related to this incident. As of the release of this community briefing, he remains in custody at the criminal justice facility awaiting further court proceedings.